If you are setting up your first home recording studio, you may come across the term XLR in equipment specifications. If you are looking to understand this connector type, Uberpad is here to help you get the basics right. In this video, we'll be covering what is an XLR interface and cable. We'll also look at why it is the preferred choice of professionals. Before we dive in, please subscribe to our channel. Also, hit the bell icon to get notified every time we post a new video. Now, let's get to it. What is an XLR? XLR stands for External Line Return. They were invented as a means of passing large electrical currents cleanly while providing a standardized connector. The XLR name comes from a particular X connector from Canon Electric, which was modified with the latch, the L, and a synthetic rubber compound, the R. They are usually found in audio devices such as speakers, mixing boards, amplifiers, microphones, and other recording equipment. You may even spot them in professional lighting equipment and certain high-end stereo amplifiers and AV receivers. Technically, XLR connectors come in various pin counts, wiring configuration, and sizes. But in this video, we're looking at only the commonly available 3-pin XLR or XLR3 connector types. A 3-pin XLR plug and socket is typically found in quality equipment for analog audio signals. XLR connectors are available in male and female versions in both cable and chassis mounting designs. Why are they preferred by professionals? One of the main reasons for their preference is that they are capable of carrying 48-volt phantom power that is needed to power condenser microphones. The second thing is that they are balanced cables. It is commonly used to deliver balanced line signals across the long distance. Let us explain how they achieve this balanced and low noise signal levels. An XLR cable has two identical signals plus a ground signal. One of the signals on the XLR cable is basically inverted and sent completely out of phase with the other. Essentially, it is flipped 180 degrees. When the signals arrive at the receiving equipment, it puts the two signals back in phase, taking a mirrored signal and reverting it to its original form. The two signals match and that's the signal that gets passed to the mixer. Because the signal is balanced, it will contain less unwanted noise from outside interference due to what is known as reverse polarity. Another important reason why XLR is preferred is that it firmly locks into the socket, so the chances of it accidentally disconnecting are close to nil. So these are all the reasons why XLR cables and connectors are popular. We plan to cover more such connector types in our future videos. Which one would you like to learn more about? Use the comment section to share your ideas and suggestions. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. Also, subscribe to our channel and follow us on social media for more such interesting and informational videos. Thank you for watching.